Welcome to English class. This is for 7th grade. We are studying phase 3, week 18, okay? This class is for 7th grade. We're studying phase 3, week 18. Today, we are going to study the following topic: introduction to simple past. Yes? So that's the topic that we're studying today: introduction to simple past. Okay? As you know, simple past refers to the past, okay? Present is what's happening right now, and past is what has already happened, okay? First, we are going to go through the guide to see what we are doing, okay? Vamos a hacer una vista general primero. First, in the activation part, tenemos una lista de verbos in present. Todos están in present. La idea es hacer un bingo con esos, okay? Es para conocer la pronunciation y la escritura de los diferentes verbos, ¿okay? La idea es que tú te puedas hacer cartoncitos de estos, ¿okay? Cada uno es un cartoncito o una cartita, por decirlo de alguna manera, o una tarjetita, ¿yes? Por decirlo de alguna manera, a little card. Y pues tomas uno de estos cuadros, ¿okay? Para jugar bingo. Y a medida vayan saliendo las tarjetitas, tú vas marcando la que va saliendo, como quien juega bingo o lotería. Yes, it's very common to say to play lotería here in El Salvador. Todos hemos jugado lotería alguna vez here in El Salvador. So the same happens here, lo mismo aquí. Yes, haces una cartita o una tarjetita, a little card, por cada uno de estos verbs, okay? Y ya cuando tienes las 4, 8, 12, 16, las 16 tarjetitas, 16 cards, las vas sacando. Y la que va saliendo, pues, la vas marcando. Y cuando ya la tienes todas, ya puedes decir bingo. Yes, bingo is similar to lotería. Yes, we play like that in El Salvador. Okay? Hay varias options de diferentes cartones de lotería, different bingo cards, so that you can play. Okay? En la presentation, here tenemos la introduction al past. Yes, estamos hablando, remember, past, yes. Present, lo que pasa en este momento. Right now, in this very moment. This is present, yes. Past, lo que ya ocurrió, okay. So we are going to learn verbs in the past. Luego le voy a mostrar una list of verbs, okay. A list of verbs, so that you can know what you're going to do. Le voy a enseñar una lista de verbos después, okay. After that, tenemos practice. Tenemos que responder, yes, in English. Pero siempre vamos a responder utilizando los verbs in the past, ¿ok? Ya les voy a enseñar cómo. And finally, se nos dice que escribamos un párrafo sobre tus días favoritos, ¿yes? Algo que te ocurrió a ti in the past, ¿ok? Un día que fue very nice, un día que fue muy magnífico, an awesome time that you had in the past, ¿ok? Algo que te pasó a ti, que fue awesome, que fue impressive, that we really liked, yes, and you describe that in English, remember, using verbs in the past, okay? Now, let's start over here in the activation part, okay? Let's practice the pronunciation of these verbs in the present, okay? Let's practice the pronunciation of these verbs in the present. Eat. Listen. Stop. Right. See. Walk. Like. Drink. Live. Cook. Play. Sleep. Love, love, love. Run, run, run. Hate, hate, hate. Study, study, study. Yes, those are verbs in present. Okay, those verbs are in present. But let me tell you something. These verbs, ellos también tienen a form in the past. Okay, también tienen una forma en el pasado. Pero la diferencia de todos estos es que la forma en que se escriben cambia. Yes, la forma en que se escriben cambia. Hemos estado hablando de verbos regulares. Yes, regular verbs in the past. Que casi todos terminan en ED, ¿ok? Prácticamente los regulares terminan en ED. Pero en el caso de los que están en este cuadro, son en su mayoría irregular verbs. En su gran mayoría son irregular verbs. ¿Yes? Y tienen que cambiar la forma en que se escribe, ¿ok? La gran mayoría de estos verbos son irregular verbs. Y tienen que cambiar la forma en que se escriben. Por eso vamos a aprender algunos de esos irregular verbs aquí en esta clase de hoy, ¿ok? Let's watch a list, vamos a ver una lista of some irregular verbs in the past, ¿ok? Try to remember that because we are going to use those verbs to answer the kind, ¿ok? Vamos a tratar de recordarla porque nos va a servir para responder algunas cosas. Esta guía, ok. In this side, en este lado, we have the present form of the verbs, yes. And in this side, we have the past form of the verbs, ok. Remember, present, past, ok. Now let's practice. Let's practice. Listen and repeat. Wake up in present. Wake up. Wake up. Walk up. Walk up. Find. Find, found, found. Want, want, wanted, wanted. Am, is, was. Okay, just a moment. Am, is the verb to be, okay? Se usa para decir yo soy, yo estoy. Do you remember? I am a student, for example. Yes. Or another example is he is good looking. Yes. So he is pretty, for example. Yes. He's good looking. But this is in present. I am is in present. He is, she is, that's present. Yes. In past will be was. Okay. For example, I was a student, yes. In the past, en el pasado, was. In present, I am. En el pasado, in the past, I was. Okay. In present, I am. In the past, en el pasado, I was. Yes. In present, he is. So, for example, he is a student. Yes. In the past, he was. Okay. Now, in the present, she is beautiful, for example, yes. In the past, she was beautiful, yes. Apréndase eso. Am, is, la misma forma es para los dos. Was, okay, was. Let's continue. Are, where. Are, where. Okay. Are también es el verbo to be. Yes, for example, in you are. For example, you can say, you are my friend. Okay? Eso es en present. Pero in the past sería, you were. Yes, you were. You were my friend. In the present, you are my friend. In the past, you were my friend. Lo mismo pasa con we, nosotros. We are the champions, for example. Yes, in the present. En el pasado, we were the champions, for example. Okay, we were the champions. The same happens with they. Okay, ellos. They are my family. That's in the present. Okay, en el presente. They are my family. In the past, they They were, yes, they were my family, okay? Apréndase eso, please. La forma de am y is, su pasado es was, y la forma de are, su pasado es were. Acuérdese, am and is son las tres formas del verb to be, okay? Remember that, please. Let's continue. Have. Brush, brushed. Put. In this case, it's equal, okay? In this case, it's equal. Put. Yes? Go, went. Walked. Run, ran. Jump, jumped. Chase, chased. Destroy, destroyed. Sit, sat. Can, could. Decide, decided. Pull, pulled. Managed. Arrived. Realized. Stayed. As you can see in these verbs, some of them are irregular. Okay? Algunos de esos son irregular verbs in the past. Son verbos irregulares. ¿Por qué decimos que son irregulares? Porque la forma en que se escriben cambia. ¿Sí? For example, wake up. Ahora es woke up. ¿Sí? The way they are written is different. So the same happens with is, are. The way they are written is different. La forma en que se escriben es diferente. You can say this part and this part, the present and the past are different. Por eso decimos, como son diferentes, son irregular. Okay? Irregular verbs in the past. Okay? Si quieres, le puedes tomar screenshot a esto. Take a screenshot of this. Okay? Take a screenshot of this. Para que lo tengas ahí guardado en tu phone, en your phone, yes? Porque estos verbs vamos a utilizarlos ahorita en la guía, okay? You can take a screenshot of this, a screenshot, captura de pantalla, you can take a screenshot, because these verbs are going to be useful in the next part of the guide, okay? Let's go back to the guide, vamos a la guía. Let's go back to the guide, yes? Now, here, aquí vamos a usar los verbos de la guía. Attention here. Esta semana aprenderás a escribir un párrafo sobre eventos del pasado. Te presentamos un texto en inglés. Aquí está más abajo, ¿yes? Te presentamos un texto en inglés que describe el día de Ben. Leer es una muy buena forma de aprender un idioma. Se aprende gramática al analizar cómo se usan los tiempos verbales y otras estructuras para enriquecer tu vocabulario. Instructions. Lee el párrafo. Attention to that. Lee el párrafo sobre el día de Ben y subraya todos los verbos en inglés. Attention. Subraya todos los verbos en inglés. Encierra en un círculo las palabras nuevas. Busca su significado y dibújalas en tu cuaderno de inglés. ¿Ok? Encierra en un círculo las palabras nuevas. Busca su significado y dibújalas en tu cuaderno de inglés. Attention, vamos a hacer dos cosas, ¿ok? Subrayar todos los verbos, ¿ok? Subrayar todos los verbos. Y luego, buscar las palabras nuevas y dibujarlas, ¿ok? Yo sé que hay muchas palabras nuevas. I know there are a lot of new words. Pero con unas 10 será suficiente, ¿ok? Yo sé que quizás de estas le salgan a lot of new words, muchas palabras nuevas. Pero con 10, that will be enough, ¿ok? De los verbos y sáquemelos todos, please. ¿Yes? De los verbos y sáquemelos todos, please. Teacher, ¿y cuáles son los verbos aquí? Son los mismos a los que le dije que le tome screenshot. Yes, the verbs here son los mismos a los que le dije que le tome screenshot. ¿Ok? Esos son los verbs. ¿Qué vamos a hacer con los verbs? Underline, subrayar. ¿Ok? So, for example, aquí hay un verb, ¿eh? Woke up. Underline. Found. Okay, another verb. Lo subrayamos. Yes. Wanted. Okay, another verb. Lo subrayamos. Yes. Was. Another verb. Yes. Have. Another verb. Have. Another verb. Yes. Brushed. Another verb. Y subrayamos. Underline, underline, underline. Teacher, ¿y cuáles son los verbos, teacher? Aquí están. Take a screenshot of the verbs so that you can remember what those verbs are. And you can underline the verbs in this paragraph. Okay? After that, cuando ya tengamos eso, aquí dice que vamos a circle, encerrar en un círculo, las palabras nuevas, the new vocabulary, y lo dibujamos in the English notebook. For example, imagine, dog. Imagine que dog sea una palabra nueva para mí. Okay? Dog. What is dog in Spanish? So it's a dog is a perro. So you draw a perro. Okay? A dog. Dibujas un perro. Okay? Now, imagine, for example, que esta palabra es nueva para mí. Home. Yes, I look it up in the dictionary, and I found out that home is a casa. Yes, I found out that home is a casa. So, hago un dibujo de la home, for example. Yes, lo mismo. Imagine que encuentro esta palabra, door, y encuentro que es una palabra nueva para mí. So, I look it up in the dictionary, and I realize that door is a puerta. Yes. A door. So I draw a door in my notebook. Dibujo una puerta en mi cuaderno. Yes. Como le digo, si son muchas, don't worry. Con una 10 será suficiente. Yes. With 10 new words, that's enough. Now, let's continue. Now here we have a practice. Yes. Lee de nuevo el párrafo sobre el día de Ben y responde las siguientes preguntas. Answer the following questions. Responde las preguntas. Answer the following questions, okay? Let's read, hay que leer here the paragraph about Ben's day and then answer, responder the questions. Okay, for example, ejemplo. Who was happy to be outside? Who was happy to be outside? The one that was happy to be outside is Fox, yes? He walked for the park, he ran and jumped. Está saltó de alegría, yes? Fox was the one who was happy to be outside. Fox. ¿Y quién es Fox? Fox is the dog. Okay? Fox is the dog. So, la pregunta. Who was happy to be outside? Who? Fox. Was. En pasado, man. Fox was happy. Yes. Happy to be outside. Okay? Si ustedes se fijan, solo cambiamos la primera palabra. Yes. Como les he dicho muchas veces, in English, las respuestas siempre se parecen a las preguntas. Another example. Okay. What did Fox do in the park? What did Fox do in the park? Okay, let's read. He ran and jumped and chased some people running. Y ahí está la respuesta, miren. He ran and jumped and chased some people running. Yes? ¿Qué hizo en el park Fox? He, el chucho, ¿verdad? He ran and jumped. Miren, en pasado, yes? Ran and jumped. Pasado, pasado. Yes? Another example. What was Ben wearing? ¿Qué estaba usando Ben? What was? Ahí está el pasado. Miren, what was Ben wearing? Okay, let's see. Aquí está, miren. Empecemos. He was wearing, él estaba usando, okay. He was wearing a jogging suit and a heavy coat. Ahí está. He was wearing a jogging suit and a heavy coat. ¿Ok? Si tiene problemas para responder estas preguntas, luego de ver el video, Puede preguntarme. Yes, you can send me a WhatsApp and I'll be happy to answer your questions. Okay? Algunas de estas cosas ya las hemos visto en semanas pasadas, como what was the weather like? It was. Okay, ¿cómo estaba el clima? What was the weather like? Y lo buscamos aquí, okay? Y vamos a ver, for example, que el clima was, dice, frozen, yes? Estaba cold, estaba chilly, seguramente. Now, to the final part. 1.4, production, okay? Escribe un párrafo sobre uno de tus días favoritos. Describe las actividades que realizaste y por qué fue un buen día. Yes. Think about a good day in your life. Piensa sobre un buen día en su vida. For example, your birthday, su cumpleaños. Yes. Póngale. Así empieza así como Ben. Yes. Tome como example la historia de Ben. When I woke up this morning. Y empieza, ¿verdad? I took a shower. Me bañé. Yes. I took a shower. I had breakfast. Desayuné. I put on. Me puse my favorite shirt, my favorite pants, yes. I went, yo fui, I went to Metro Centro, I went to Garita Palmera Beach, okay, for example. Todo lo que usted hizo en ese día maravilloso that you liked, okay. Escriba un párrafo, okay. In English, of course. If you have any questions, you can send me a WhatsApp. Antes de terminar, I want to show you a video, yes. I want to show you a video so that you can see how to express yourself in the past. Para ver cómo puede expresarse en el pasado. Okay? Let's watch it. Veámoslo. Antes de empezar, debo decir que no tengo los derechos de autor de este video. Lo he tomado de English Sing Sing. Puedes unirse a ese canal, English Sing Sing. Okay? Le voy a dejar el link ahí en la descripción para que lo vea y se una. Let's listen and try to learn how to pronounce the verbs in the past, okay? Let's listen.
Good morning, Sally. How are you?
I'm great. What did you do yesterday?
We went to the park.
What did you do in the park?
We flew kites. His kites flew high.
Wow, you're good.
What did you do yesterday, Sally?
I read books.
Let's go to the classroom.
What did you do yesterday?
I watched a science movie.
What did you do yesterday, Mike?
I made bulgogi with my dad.
How was it?
It was very delicious. We had a bulgogi party.
I made cookies yesterday. I brought cookies for you.
Thanks. Delicious.
Let's role play.
Okay, now let's have a practice. Yes? Let's have a practice. Let's try to listen and repeat, okay, the pronunciation of those words. Good morning, Sally. How are you? I'm great. What did you do yesterday? Listen. What did you do yesterday? What did you do yesterday? ¿Qué hiciste ayer? Yes. What did you do yesterday? We went to the park. What did you do in the park? What did you do in the park? We flew kites. His kites flew high. Wow, you're good. What did you do yesterday, Sally? Attention over there. What did you do yesterday? What did you do yesterday? ¿Qué hiciste ayer? What did you do yesterday, Sally? I read books. Let's go to the classroom. What did you do yesterday? Listen and repeat. What did you do yesterday? What did you do yesterday? I watched a science movie. What did you do yesterday, Mike? I made bulgogi with my dad. How was it? It was very delicious. We had bulgogi party. I made cookies yesterday. I brought cookies for you. Thanks. Delicious. Okay? If you want to watch the video, okay, you can do it on your own and practice that pronunciation, okay? Remember, what did you do yesterday? ¿Qué hiciste ayer? Yes? What did you do yesterday? ¿Qué hiciste ayer? Okay? Y la respuesta, in the past, verbos in the past, okay? So that's it for today. If you have any questions, you can send me a WhatsApp and I'll be more than happy to answer your questions, okay? Bye guys and see you next week.